When it comes to today's transmission application, when it comes to today's transmission application, it is a continuously variable planetary and change the way mechanical power is transmitted to improve the performance and the flexibility of transmission for a greener future. New Vinci CVP technology provides improved transmission performance and flexibility in everything from bicycle, automotive accessory drives, electric vehicles, lawn care equipment to small wind turbines and beyond. New Vinci technology, which can be manufactured at a low cost globally with standard industrial materials and process, has been commercialized is scalable across various applications and can be applied across a diverse array of markets and produced with significant process and tooling carryover from product to product. Salzburg has strong partnership in place in a number of industries, providing production validation and pathway to further commercialization. Then there is some benefits that, for example, does not compromise full efficiency for performance, provides a smooth continuous progression from one speed to another with no abrupt radial change of harsh gear engagements. Compact packaging requires less space. Flexible packaging into either U or through their configuration, allow engine or motor to operate at speed of peak efficiency or power. Another benefit is the high torque density, less complexity, scalable technology that can be used in a variety of applications, and it can be manufactured with standard materials and no process.
New Vinci Technologies is a continuously variable planetary, or CVP, that is based on a set of rotating tilting balls fitted between two rings. Figure 1 illustrates the basic components of the New Vinci CVP technology. As shown in figure, the New Vinci technology has an input disc or ring driven by the power source, an output disc or ring connected to the CVP output, a set of balls, each rotating on its own axle, and fitted between the input disc, output disc, and the central sun to help maintain the balls in position. Torque from an engine, motor, or other input source. It's transferred through the input disc to the balls using a thin layer or of traction fluid. The torque is then transmitted through the balls to the output disc, another thin layer of traction fluid. The input disc and output disc are clamped onto the balls thickly so that the required amount of clamping force is provided for the amount of torque being transmitted. However, as indicated above, torque is transmitted through the traction fluid, which prevents destructive metal to metal contact between the balls and discs, while providing traction for the balls and rings and lubrication for bearings and the other components. The speed of the output disc compared to the speed of the input disc, or speed ratio, is controlled by the angle of the balls axis relative to the axis of the transmission. Figure 1 also illustrates that tilting the balls axle shift the transmission from low to high, as shown left to right, or from high to low, or to any ratio in between. The number of balls used depends on several factors, including torque and speed requirement. Unlike a conventional transmission that have a fixed number of gear ratios, a continuously variable transmission or CVT has an unlimited numbers of ratios within its particular ratio range from low to high. The use of CVT compared to a conventional transmission facilitates operating the power source and an optimum speed, which usually occurs where the power source is either most efficient of its producing its highest power or torque. While the power source is typically an engine or motor, it can also be human power and as in a bicycle. When used in an automotive transmission, CVTs improve performance by allowing the engine or motor to continuously deliver peak power to the drivetrain, while steadily allowing the speed of the vehicle to increase total acceleration. When power demands are below peak levels, the power source is allowed to operate and its most efficient possible condition for the power level demanded by the users. This also improves efficiency by allowing the vehicle's engine to operate at or near its most efficient speed, while vehicle speed varies. By allowing engines to operate at their most efficient speed when the highest power isn't needed, the CVT optimized the overall system efficiency, reduce fuel consumption and the emission, and their associated adverse effect of the environment. Besides automobiles, the potential benefits of CVPs are similar, applicable to many other mechanical systems that require variation between the speed of primary drive and the speed required to operate the mechanical system. NuVinci is unique among CVTs in that it's, in technical terms, a compound variable planetary drive. NuVinci technologies can also be configured to be an infinitely variable driving going smoothly and continuously from reverse throat, a power neutral, to forward.
As we know, their motors have a very low efficiency with respect to electric motor. Their consumption is twice. If we use the CVT with high level of efficiency, we can optimize their motor consumption and achieve higher autonomy respect to the current solution.